Do you know what voice is, Chris?
Males have harsh voice and females have soft voice, is it?
Yes, but no.
Then males have louder voice and females have high-pitched voice, is it?
Of course not. We are not in the science class. Let's find it out in Google.
In grammar, the voice of a verb describes the relationship between the action or state that the verb expresses and the participants identified by its arguments, subject, object, etc.
Isn't it too difficult?
Nah, it isn't.
When the subject is the agent or doer of the action, the verb is in the active voice. When the subject is the action, the verb is said to be in the passive voice. Voice is sometimes called diathesis.
Diathesis, is it some kind of treatment?
Shut up, Chris.
Transformation of voice from active to passive is called voice change or change of voice.
Have you seen the Transformers?
Let's go, Chris. You are very disturbing.
But, Aaron, no. Wait, Aaron. Will you teach me about the voice?
Of course not. I am not a teacher, but I know one who is.
Who is it?
It is our beloved Madam Rose.
Good morning, ma'am. I am Madam Rose. Aaron knows me. Hi, Chris. I heard of you from Aaron. He said that you want to learn about voice. I have another student with me. Meet Steve.
Hi everyone, I am Steve.
So, do you know anything about boys, Chris?
No, madam.
As expected.
Insult, Chris.
Aaron.
As you know, voices are of two types. We will start with the active voice, okay? Active voice means that a sentence has a subject that acts upon its verb.
Madam, can you give me some examples?
Yes. He watches a movie. She is playing chess. She has watched the circus. She has been studying for 2 hours. You understand?
Yes, madam.
Good. Then give me at least 8 examples of active voice in past and future tenses.
She watched Avengers Endgame. She was watching Avengers Endgame. She had watched Avengers Endgame. She had been watching Avengers Endgame for 2 hours.
Good, Chris. Now, Steve, continue this.
Okay, madam. She will go for tuition. He will be playing video games. He will have done 10 sums till then. She will have been playing piano for an hour.
Incredibly good, Steve.
You know nothing except Endgame, Chris.
I think you have learnt about active voice. Now let's take a step forward and learn about another type of voice, that is passive voice.
Okay, madam.
So let's begin. It is quite simple and interesting, and I'm sure you will enjoy this.
Madam, I'm extremely excited.
You become excited too easily, my dear excite battery.
A verb is in the passive voice when its form shows that something is done to the person or thing denoted by the subject. The passive voice is so called because the person or the thing denoted by the subject is not active, but passive, that is, suffers or receives some action. See here. In active, the sentence will be Tim hit the ball, where Tim is the subject, hit is the action, and the ball is the object. And if we change it into passive, it will be the ball was hit by Tim, where the ball, which was the object in active, will be the subject in passive. Was hit by will be the action, and Tim, which was the subject in active, will come at last in the passive. Now, Aaron, give me some examples.
For sure, madam. A letter is written by him. Then a song is being sung by her. and the work has been completed by him.
Understood, dears?
Yes, madam.
Great. Now give me some examples of passive voice in past simple, past continuous, past perfect, future simple, and future perfect tense, Steve.
Sure, madam. The car was bought by him. A shirt was being washed by her. The game had been won by them. A poem will be written by her. The letter will have been received by them.
Great, you people are catching up quickly.
Thanks, madam.
This catching quickly must have the same reason from West. Actually, only Steve and I are catching up quickly. Huh.
Madam, why are we studying these stuffs? What's their use?
Wow, I was just going to tell you about this. Good, Chris. So, let's come to the topic again. What's it?
Yes, madam.
Writers need to be intentional about voice in order to ensure clarity. Using active voice often improves clarity, while passive voice can help avoid unnecessary repetition. Active voice can help ensure clarity by making it clear to the reader who is taking action in the sentence.
Madam, kindly wait. We did not understand a bit.
So, did it all go in vain? Didn't you guys understand anything?
I guess no.
Madam, can I say?
Yes, for sure, Erin.
What Madam was saying was that writers and speakers have different writing and speaking styles, have different preferences. So, to make the test push beating or to the point, the use of passive and active voice is done in respective conditions.
Exceptionally good, Erin.
Thank you, Madam.
So is it now clear to you, my dear students?
Yes, madam.
I see. It's time. I got to go. Thank you, students.
Thank you so much, madam.
Thank you so much, madam.